Now, Eric, I mentioned that scientists and engineers have been designing embedded systems based on the LabVIEW Rio architecture for nearly 10 years. So what we wanted to do was bring out an engineer that was there with us in the beginning. For those of you that were here 6 years ago, you might remember Mike Wiltberger, principal engineer and founder of Optimedica.
Jamie, if they were here 6 years ago, they definitely remember Mike Wiltberger.
Yeah, let's take a look back.
I've been using LabVIEW and LabVIEW products for over 15 years, and I built a career and even a company on your products. And I just want to thank National Instruments for helping us change the world of ophthalmology. Thank you.
There's the man.
All right. Himself. Welcome, Mike. Woo! So Mike's here to talk to us about a completely different machine that treats cataracts.
The first thing I want to say is I hope everybody here gets cataracts.
Whoa, Mike. I've known you for a long time, and that's got to be the strangest thing I've ever heard you say.
I hope everybody has a long, happy life, and if you live long enough, you're probably going to get cataracts. You know, starting in your 30s and into your 40s, your lens starts to get hard, and you lose the ability to focus things up close, you know. This is called presbyopia, and everybody's going to get it. It's just a normal part of getting old. There's a couple of remedies for this. One is to get a book and get those Inspector Gadget arms that kind of puts it way out there, or you can get reading glasses. The lens is held in a bag right behind the iris, and the light entering the eye is focused on the retina. As you get in your 50s and 60s, the lens darkens and hardens, and the light is scattered on the retina. The remedy for this is to remove the lens and replace it with a new synthetic lens. You can see that it focuses it right back down.
Great. So why don't we talk about the treatment of cataracts and how it's done today?
The first thing you do is use a scalpel to poke some holes in the cornea there. Then this little pick is used to kind of create a circle in that bag around the lens. And this is like tearing a piece of paper. You can try this. Try and take a piece of paper and tear it into, don't do it now, do it in your first session. And then when you have them, give them to Eric. He'll judge them for you. But you can see what can happen when you're tearing that stuff. Then this phaco device comes in. It's a vibrating suction device. And you're in there and you're turning the lens around and you're sucking it out. And then you use this injector and you put the new lens in there. It's like a taco and it go pop.
So
right? Check this out. It's really important that that capsulotomy, that's what that circle is called, is in the right place because it shrink wraps itself around the lens and holds the lens in there. You can see that one's not so good.
Yeah, I saw everyone squirming. And I should point out, this is true, Mike wanted to show an actual surgical video of that procedure instead of the animation on that giant screen. And we wouldn't let him do it.
What I want you to do is have a big free lunch, right? And then get like the, I think it's the cherry cobbler, and come over to the Xilinx booth, and I'll show you some videos. We'll have a good time.
Yeah, go check that out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it seems like having a nice circular hole in the eye is important to the procedure. What else is really critical to making this procedure go successful?
Well, it's really critical to be gentle, especially in the elderly. You don't want to elevate the pressure inside the eye. And you probably don't want this this jackhammer in the eye for too long. That's probably not good either. And you don't want to break the back of the bag because it's called the vitreous humor. I call it the eye goop, where it kind of like push its way into where the lens is, and that's not good.
You have trouble.
You have trouble, okay. Yeah. Now, if you look at this up here, you can see that this instrument is really the poster child for National Instruments. Everything is wrapped around LabVIEW. The front panel communicates to the main LabVIEW program. Then we have a Gigi camera using NI Vision, We have an OCT, that's our optical coherence tomography. It's our three-dimensional device, so when we put the laser inside your eyes, we know exactly where we're going. That uses the National Instruments Fast Analog Input DAC, and then, of course, the FPGA, the R-Series board with the Xilinx FPGA in it, and that just touches everything in our system. We have foot pedals, we're controlling the laser, controlling the chair. All these things are going on, and everything goes through the FPGA.
Excellent, Mike. Okay, well, let's take a look at Catalys. Let's look at the machine.
Okay, the doctor or the patient is laid down on the bed, and this is what it has inside it is a femtosecond laser in there. That's femtosecond, 10 to the minus 15. Okay, and it has a 5-micron spot. We use that spot and we control it in X, Y, and Z. It's sort of like micro machining in the eye. We can make a perfect capsule orexis, sort of like that piece of paper, any size we want, and we can put it anywhere in the eye. We can also kind of dice or fragment the lens into pieces so you don't have to use a lot of phaco energy to suck it out. Sometimes they don't use any. So the patient is lying down on the bed and it gets a patient interface. It's a little rubber device here, and it sucks to the eye. So the doctor will suck it to the eye, put the patient underneath the machine, and actually drive them up to a locked position. As soon as we're in a locked position, an OCT scan takes over, and we get to see what's inside the eye. Every morning, the nurse will set up all the procedures, all the parameters for the whole day. So the doctor just has to come in, make sure that our OCT scan. This is a three-dimensional scan. You can see two 90-degree slices of that. And the most important thing is how well we're fitting spheres to these optical surfaces found in the OCT data. If I turn them off and on, you can see. And this red zone right here is a don't fire zone. We don't want to fire the bottom of the lens. You want to keep that happy there. So the doctor checks that out, and all he has to say is, I approve it. He hits a foot pedal, and right here is an animation, laser capsule orexis. Here's fragmentation in the lens, and now we get to see a real one. Quick capsule orexis, quick fragmentation. The laser ionizes the actual material of the lens and turns it into a gas, and you can see it bubble up there. And there's a perfect lens sitting right there.
Very cool.
Mike, and we can see the capsulotomy on the right. The Catalys did nice round uniform circles. The manual procedure, not as uniform, jagged around the edges. Is that what we're supposed to be seeing here?
That's exactly. You can see the doctors do a pretty good job, which you guys are going to find out later in your first session. But ours looks a little bit better.
Yeah,
it does.
Well, Mike, you know, congratulations to you and the team at Optimedica. You've built another amazing application. I understand that you recently got awarded an R&D 100 award, so congratulations.
Congratulations, Mike.
Thanks for that. We're really proud of that, but that's not why we do it. Let's take a look at the first patient in the U.S. to have the Catalys procedure.
I mean, it was so easy, and it was done so quickly, you don't feel anything at all. And you have this really amazing vision. I have my first eye done. They lifted me off the table, and I sat up, and they said, how was it? And I said, it was fabulous. I couldn't believe it. You know, I could see everything.
To
look
right
at something
away.
And to be able to read it when you haven't been able to for so long. It's so exciting.
That's fantastic.
I met with one of our patients who was an 85-year-old lady. Before the procedure, she had 2400 vision. That's pretty bad. After the procedure, she had 2015, and that's better than hindsight. Thank you for laughing at that one. Thank you. Anyways, this elderly lady has the best eyesight of her life. And I was thinking, you know, maybe getting old won't be so bad. Thank you. See you in 6 years.
Oh, there you go.